So when we are using EPANET, of course, for better results, there are some few settings that we need to have in place, either during hydraulic modeling or before we even start drawing a water network. Today, that is something I want to share with you. And if you're new here, my name is Engineer Lodrick, and this is Hydroinformatics Academy, a place where we discuss about technologies related to water supply and irrigation. So if you're interested, let's get started. Okay, so this is my EPANET software, which is version 2.2, and this is my workspace. So the first setting is to actually going from here. Let me select project. Let me go straight to project, then select defaults. This is the little window that we are going to have. Of course, from here we have like three tabs. The first one here is ID labels, then properties. Lastly, we have the hydraulics. Okay, so what we need to do is that we need to assign labels for every element, like for every junctions, reservoirs, and tanks. And from here, what we can do is to assign, like, for every junction that I'm going to introduce in my model, to have a certain label. Let's say junction hyphen 1, junction hyphen 2, junction hyphen 3. Okay, so by default, EPANET is going to take this junction, this J hyphen, and going to assign it with 1. Let's say junction hyphen 1, junction hyphen 2, and so on and so forth. The same applies to reservoirs. If I have like three reservoirs and I want to assign them, let's say with R hyphen 1, R hyphen 2, R hyphen 3, then we need to assign this parameter here. And again, for storage tanks, we need to make sure that at least for every storage tank that we have in our model, or we're going to introduce in our model, we have like a storage tank hyphen 1 or ST hyphen 1, like ST hyphen 1, ST hyphen 2, ST hyphen 3, and so on and so forth. For pipes, the same. What we need to do here, for every pipe or for every link that we are going to introduce in our model, at least we want them to have like a P hyphen 1, P hyphen 2, and so on and so forth. So from here in labels, we need to assign it with P hyphen. Then for pumps, let's say like you have three pumps. Okay, we need to have like a label to present our pumps. So from here, I can just opt to go with PMP. Of course, you can even go with P, but because P is taken here already, let me introduce PMP, then hyphen. So if you have like three pumps, PMP1, PM2, PMP hyphen 1, PMP hyphen 2, and then hyphen 3. For valves, let me introduce V, then hyphen. For patterns, of course, I can introduce P, but P is taken here already. I can say like PT, then hyphen. Then curves, I will do the same, like CV, then hyphen. By the way, we have introduced one-to-one training session, and it will be conducted from 16th of this month. So if you are interested and you want to know more about this live training, EPANET training, just go to the description. I'll make sure that I include the link to that announcement video in the description below. That being said, let's proceed with our tutorial. The next setting here that we need to have is properties. Okay, let me select the properties. So from here you can see we have the default values. So for node elevation, by default is 0. Of course you can change if you want, but by default is 0. And also the tank diameter by default is 50. By default here is 50, but for me, I opted to go with 10. Of course, the tank height by default here is 10, but for me, I opted to go it with 3. Of course, feel free to change if you want. And again, the pipe length value is 10 by default. So the auto length is off. You can assign it with on if you want. So what auto length is going to do is quite simple. So let's say you have like two junctions, and you want to introduce the link between those two junctions, and you want EPANET to calculate the length of that link. So if you want EPANET to calculate the length of that link, by default, you are going to set here to on. But if you don't want that and you want to assign the length of the link manually, then make sure that you set this one to off. Then we have the pipe diameter, which is assigned to 12 by default. You can change if you want. And lastly, the pipe roughness coefficient, which is 100. If you want, you can change it as well. The next important, very, very important setting is hydraulic. So from here, I can just go here. Of course, in my window, let me select this hydraulics. You can see here we have the first one as a flow units. To command EPANET to use SI unit, we need to set these settings here. So from here, I need to select either LPS or LPM, or even this one, which is a million liters a day. So if you select any of these three, you are going to assign, or you are going to force EPANET to use the SI unit. But if you want to use the empirical units, okay, empirical units for your software, what you need to do is to select is to select any of these ones, like CFS, which is cubic feet second, or the gallon per minute. Okay, so if you select any of these ones here, automatically you are going to force EPANET to use the empirical system. But for me, I want to use the SI units, then I'll select this as LPS. And again, the other one, which is head loss formula. We all know that when water is moving within the pipe, encounters some few head losses. And to estimate those head losses, we have like common formulas that we normally use. The first one being the Hazen-Williams, and the other one being the Das-Weisbach. But for me, I want to set it to Hazen-Williams. Of course, you can even set the specific gravity. For water, the default value here is 1, and also the relative viscosity here is 1 as well. But if you are working with other fluids than water, then make sure that you assign the required specific gravity here. So if you are working, let's say, with gas or with petroleum products, make sure that you assign here the specific gravity for that particular fluid. Otherwise, you're going to have the wrong results. And the other one here is the maximum trials. So let's say you run your model. EPANET is going to run several iterations to make sure that it attains to the best possible result for your model. Okay, so the maximum value here, we set it as 40. So what does that mean is that EPANET will run a maximum of a 40 trial to attain the possible best result for your model. Of course, after you click run. And also we have accuracy, and also we have the if the model or if the solution is unbalanced, then you can even continue, but you can even opt with stop. So what does this mean is that if the solution is not balanced, or if the model is not balanced, then EPANET will stop altogether. But if you want EPANET to continue, even if the system or the solution is not balanced, then you can click continue. Of course, by default, the value here is continue. The other one here is the pattern. Of course, these ones here, I don't see if we have anything we can change, but just know that we have those settings. Lastly, if you are satisfied with these settings and you want to use these settings even for the next project, okay, what you can do is to set this, okay, and say like save as default for all new projects. So from now on, these are the settings that you are going to use. But if you want to change your settings even for the next, when you start the next project, you can just ignore this one. Otherwise, you can set, okay. Okay, so from here, let me click OK. The next setting is analysis option. And to set this, what we need to do is to go straight to projects, then select defaults. Then select analysis options. So from here, this is what we are going to have. Of course, most of the settings here we have gone through already, like flow units, then head loss formula. Then from here, the most important setting is the demand model. By default, it's set to DDA, but we have the other option, which is PDA. By the way, these are the two important terms that we normally use in EPANET, of course, in hydraulic modeling in general, the DDA and PDA. So in short, DDA is a demand-driven analysis, and also PDA is pressure-driven analysis. I have a full video which explains the meaning and the difference between the two terms, so make sure that you go to the description. I'll make sure that I'm including the link to that video in the description below. Okay, so for our case, we are going to use the demand-driven analysis, okay? And also we have some other options down here, like the minimum pressure, the required pressure, and also the pressure exponent, and so on and so forth. So for me, I don't have anything I can change from here. I'll just close at this one. The other one, the other settings, which is very simple, is nothing but workplace background. For now, here we have like the white color, but what I want is to change this color, okay? So if you want to change this color, it's quite simple. You can just right click here and click options. You have these options here. So let me go back here. You can see this is the background. By default here is white, but if you want to use this color as well, you can change all this one, okay? But for me, I normally prefer to use the white color as a background color. The other setting is nothing but the project summary. And for that, it's quite simple. Let me go back here. Let me select file. Then let me select page setup. So from here, what you can do is to write the information about your project. Let me say at the header of my page, I want to display like ABC company. And at the footer of my page, I want to display like XYZ project. Okay, so if I click OK, then this information will be displayed on each and every page of my EPANET report. So let me click OK. The other one here is preferences. Okay, preference. Let me select file, then select preference. We have like few options here, but the most important one here is for node parameters, we want to display. So for node parameters like demand, head, pressure, and quality, we want to display them into two decimal places. So if you want to display them like for one decimal place, you can change it from here. But for link parameters as well, like flow, velocity, unit head losses, and so forth, we want to display them again for within two decimal places. Of course, you can change them if you want, but by default, this is the values that we have. Okay.